topic is about robotic multipurpose grazing. As we all know that cattle use is a major sector of agriculture, and forgetting that our survival is dependent on agriculture. Nowadays the farmers are using the old traditional methods in their farming, so it is a very good idea to use this robotic feeder in their farming. In this robot we have a scanner which scans the wheat and drops the wheat with a dropper, and it will change the blade to here. In this side it will work as a harvester, and in this robotic feeder we can also insert the software. For example, if we insert a software of soil detector, this robot will detect the soil and use the notification of the soils which are lacking in the soil. And after that, this robotic feeder is also used in various sectors by serving the labor. This robotic feeder will do all the works of it. Labor. Here we don't need any type of labors to work. We can do the harvesting, spraying, weeding, seeding, etc. And with unmanned robot. Here we don't need any manpower also, because here you can say that here are buttons by which we will on this robot and we will do all the work of a man, single man.
It is a great message to Javeshnan from 6th standard. It is an interesting alphabetic scheme. It is good for physical students. Please try to play and say your experience. Now I will say the rules of the game. There are 26 paper glasses. On each glass we have written a letter from A to Z. We mix it with glasses and
this game is one, so if you want to play it.
This is the glasses I'm arranging it. One by one you take the glasses and find out the first letter. When you get first letter A, you move the glasses again and find out the next glass. The glass which is existing letter B. Like this you have to play this game. In 1 minute how many will you arrange? You will count your score and appreciate. It is a lucky game. Let's play. Have a good time.
Okay. In standard in Ravindra High School, where my topic is about ESO. India's organization is the state agency of the economy of the India. It is in the Bangalore. So, hybrid based model of GSLB. GSLB means the polar satellite launch vehicle, which is usually to launching the satellite in polar orbit. And it is GSLB also. GSLB means geosynchronous satellite launch vehicle, which is used to launch the satellites in the geostation orbit. So it is a very good idea. I use it here for mandates to operate it. In this way, you can operate it.
Thank you.